John was a very, I don't want to say aggressive, he was very competitive, and side hackings were, riding a side hack was, came very natural to him. And he had some great abilities on that hack, and he had a way of throwing that hack around that made me respect it. My goal was to get out in front of him and keep him behind me, but he had a way of coming back around, and we had some good battles.
He was the most exciting racer to ever get on the hack. When he got out there and did his thing, everyone would stop at the track and run to the side of the track just to watch JP and Doug in the side hack class, because they were just all the way wide open, no restrictions, and they just were the best, simply the best.
Dude was great. He's an insane guy. He's a good dude. He's got a big mouth and he's got a big heart too. But a lot of people tend to forget that.
He was an innovator, especially in the hacks, but also could ride really well. Wasn't afraid of anything. He was fearless. That's Johnny. Just always wanted to try something new, something different. Always wanted to go faster, fly higher. He was crazy that way. Fearless. Really fearless.
It is truly an honor for me to bring up somebody who I've always admired and somebody who I can call a true close friend. Let's hear it for JP, Johnny Pofferman. That's gonna be hard to follow up. Well, I'm JP, so that's easy for me to do. PK, you are the bomb, baby. That did bring some chills, because that was, he ain't lying. That was the Yamaha Gold Cup, and that was probably one of the most famous. That was one hell of a race. Anyway, I'd like to thank everybody for coming out. Also, first of all, I'd like to thank all those guys had just qualified for our Olympic team, because they were out there kicking some, oh, that looked good today, baby. When I look out at those guys, I just want to let them know one thing. You better get busy, baby, because I've been out there and it ain't easy. You go half around the world, you'll find out that once you stand underneath that American flag, it'll change you. I've raced not my BMX world, but in sidecar motocross. Thanks for my dad and everything. I've been a lot of places because of what we've all going through and will go through with all our kids and everything. You always want to end up being better than your father or looking up to something like that, which my dad's here today, and that's my idol. I know PK. A lot of people. I, like he said, I wasn't in the sport that long because I had a lot more business to get busy with. You know, you kind of go through levels and stages in your life, and BMX is definitely one of the highlights of my life. I'm really honored to be in this tonight. I'd like to thank Rick, obviously, Rick Toomey, who is by far one of the biggest innovators of the BMX sport. Like Perry said, we had an advantage on everybody because Rick Toomey put more time into everything and took more care of us than anybody out in the industry. He is the soul and heart of Rick's Bike Shop, which when we were riding, he took care of everything. We were in his van. We went to every race. I don't care who you were or who you thought you were. We were there kicking your butt. You know, whether it was Scott Bryant up in Long Beach. That was the second track we whooped your ass. Then we, you know, and then, you know, I mean, you know, people started looking. I said, okay, who are you? Okay, well, whatever. I said, most people say, well, what were you? I said, I quit racing when I had to pedal on a flat track. Sorry, Stu Thompson, that's when I quit. No. But anyway, We were the downhill crew is what I call our guys now. You know what I mean? If it wasn't fast, we didn't do it. Yeah. We got Ernie Alexander out there in the crowd. He said, JP, what are you going to say? I said, I'm going to tell it like it always is. Ernie goes, oh, hell, we're going to have a rough night tonight. You know, I'm not going to cry, but Ernie, where are you? There he is back there. This is ABA. No, no, the NBA, baby. I don't know who gave us the ceremony, but I remember Ernie always used to tell us, he said, the bigger the track, the harder it fall. We had Randall Ranch, Soledad Sands, like I said, Hannah. We raced anybody that was somebody was out there. And if you had anything to cry about, it didn't happen. We just take you out, and Ernie would say, sorry. My favorite story with Ernie was, we were out there one time, and this is John George, and he had a whole clan of little Canoga clowns from Swin. With George and his sidekicks against Rick's Bike Shop. All right, well, hold on. George bring out his clown show to Soledad Sands, which I owned, because I built the track. It was one of the most famous tracks ever there was. So we get on the first thing, and it's me against 7 Canoga, 8 Canoga, whatever that was. So we come down the first turn, and all John George, he's on a pedal master all the time. John George, yeah, he's in the BMX Hall of Fame. But that's what he did. He was real fast off the line like Hannah. So not me. I was always the grand finale kind of guy. So he gets out in the lead, and all his little sidekicks would be trying to smash me on the first turn there. So I took, you know, all right, now they pissed me off. So that's a big track back in the old days. A lot longer than this one here, you know. You're going down the country bunking miles. Anyway, we take out, every turn I'm taking out one Canoga there. Bang, 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 bang. All right, I got about 7 Canogas down. And I got one more, that's John George. So they used to have a big monster jump down at Yardell at the bottom, which was a spectacular jump. Yardell was a hell of a track. Anyway, I mean, I saw that chance. So I fly by John George on that last thing and take him out. So they had a little Japanese guy who used to run at Russ Okinawa. He was the team captain of that team. So he comes up and he comes over to Ernie and he says, Ernie, that damn Johnny Potman, you got to disqualify him. Ernie said, what are you talking about? He said, he took out 7 of my dudes. I said, Ernie looked at him and laughed. He goes, okay, let me figure this out. Johnny Pofferman, 7 Canoga clowns. How can I disqualify him? He won the race. You know what I mean? That's Ernie, baby. It was whoever got to the bottom of the hill was the winner. And that's how we used to do it. You know, there wasn't like, okay. The other story I got is, I hate to say it, but I started the actual starting gate. Because we used to have rubber band starts back in the old day. That didn't last long with me, because I always knew I'm jumping that. So next thing you know, he said, oh, JP, over here, Randall Ranch, which was a straight downhill. He said, we got to keep JP from jumping that thing. Well, hey, we got the guy up there. How are you going to disqualify you? It took too long to get all the things going on. So they made the ramps, which now everyone goes and puts their bike up against. Well, we jumped them too. So, hey, Sue Ann, I see you out there. Can you hear me now? I love that guy. But as the story goes, and you look to the left and to the right, you'll see, like Perry said, Riggs Bike Shop's all over this place. Everything's got to start somewhere. And I hate to say it, I started it all. And look what we got now, baby. It's all on like Donkey Kong, baby. We're in the Olympics. That's right, baby. You go, boys. We don't want nothing but gold. They were telling me about some Australians and some other clowns. Believe me, I've been out there. I take them all out. USA, all the way. USA, all the way, baby. Yeah. That's how we do it. And of course, I'm going to have to thank, yeah, who gives you this thing? The ABA, NBA now? It's ABA, all right. BMX Hall of Fame. All right, well, I'm still trying to figure out how seven other clowns on my team got there before me. Clinton and Sinus, but whatever. I guess they stayed in the industry a lot longer than I did. Because I was out busy kicking butt on the whole planet. But, you know, bicycle riding, that, you know, I got to keep up with my dad, man. That's a king right over there, you know. Sidecar racer, you know, whatever. You know, you can only go so slow, so fast for so long. I need a throttle. I used to crank a 950cc motocross sidecar, and somebody knows me then. Yeah. But anyway, make a long story short. Thanks, everybody. Have a good time. Woo! Rick's Bike Shop!